going on YouTube, and welcome back to another video from the Dinar family. Right now it's just me because I'm at home by myself with the baby, and while he is asleep I'm going to try to work out. As you all might know, I am about to be 2 months postpartum and I am cleared to work out, so I'm going to try to lose all of this belly fat. Like y'all already know, I've already lost a lot of weight, so don't get on this video and be like, she's skinny though. That's not the point. We're trying to be fit, we're trying to be healthy, and we're trying to get back right, okay? This is what my belly look like, y'all. And this is 2 months postpartum. And something I forgot to mention, y'all, this is a belly fat workout. It's a 14-day challenge. Today is day one. Also, the channel I am working out to is Mr. and Miss Muscle, okay? Go check them out. Lose some weight, get fit, be healthy, feel good, okay? Yes, all right? Good. Hey, hey, feel good. Hey. Hey, feel good. So I was on round two of the workout and somebody has decided to wake up, so let's go upstairs, see what's going on. Whew, that's how you run up the stairs. Hey buddy, what's going on? Mommy was working out, what's the problem? Say good morning to the vlog. Say good morning. Say, I don't want my mommy to lose any of her belly fat. None of it. Yeah. Is that true? Oh. Say, excuse me. Say, excuse me. I didn't mean to burp in your face.
Now that Uriah is awake, I'm gonna just go ahead and have some breakfast. Let me tell y'all what I'm finna eat.
Okay, focus, focus. I don't know why the camera won't focus.
All right, so we got Eggo waffles for days. You feel me? Hello? Hello? I know some of y'all gonna be looking at this vlog. Look at my baby. Some of y'all gonna be looking at this vlog and y'all gonna be like, so you trying to work out and you eating chocolate chip waffles and drinking coffee with all this sugar? Yes. Yes, I am. Mind your business. Even though I told you my business, but mind your business, okay? Okay, tell them, okay? Being a stay-at-home mom is honestly lovely, but at the same time, you really got to know how to juggle everything. I know y'all seen in like our update video how I was talking about sometimes you have to sacrifice stuff, and you really do. So like right now I'm sacrificing my workout time, and really, all right, let's be real. I can still work out and sit this baby down, but he just would be hollering. But I ain't trying to hear him holler right now, and I ate, so I might as well just hold baby, fix him something to eat, and just sit on until he go to sleep again. But you know, sometimes if we trying to get something done, you just gotta put the baby down and let him cry. Let him cry. And then right, Uriah, I don't know why he don't want to look. Every time, there you go. There you go. You
Ooh, that baby. Mommy love you. Do you love mommy? Blink if you love mommy. Yay! All right, y'all, so I got my 3 waffles in this pan. You know what? I don't know why I'm playing with myself. I'm finna eat more than 3 waffles. Let me fill this up. I don't know why I'm playing. But y'all, so the Eggo waffles, they have this resealable tape on it now. Y'all see that? I don't think they used to have that. I don't think so, but I haven't had them in a while. But it's very useful, especially like, you know, if you get tired of like your stuff getting freezer burnt and tasting like freezer, you can just reseal it with a little tape. Yeah, but that's what I'm talking about, okay? And don't y'all be talking about me because they little. Don't be like, you eating 6 more. They little. Nah. But okay, let me show y'all about this tape. I'm gonna roll this part down like that, okay? And then you take the tape. Focus. Hello. Take this tape and then go like that. Boom. And it's sealed. It's sealed. Look, I gotta stand all the way back here with the baby and just put my hand up like this and go like this so that I don't burn the baby. Cause baby, it's dangerous trying to do stuff with the baby in the kitchen. Better back, back. You're gonna burn the baby foot. Ain't that right, Uriah? Tell him. Okay. All right. This is my little Keurig thingy. And, you know, it spin like that so I can come here and be like, what kind of coffee I want? All right, let me check on these waffles because, y'all, I really be burning them. Yeah, that's good right now. Y'all see my waffles? Oh! I'm running into stuff.
Let me ask you how you are. You just have to say that you're fine. You're not really fine, but you just can't get into it because they would get
So, let's get down into the nitty gritty and what y'all really want to know. For the postpartum care after I had Uriah, y'all, I did not realize how much bleeding it would be after you have a baby. You know, everybody tells you that, hey, you're gonna be bleeding, but you don't really know exactly how much you are going to be bleeding. And for those of you who do not know, I had Uriah naturally with no epidural, period. After I had the baby, they had tons and tons and tons of pads laid out. These pads are, I don't know what you call them. I'll probably insert a picture somewhere. I call them little pee-pee pads or whatever. I don't know what the real name is, but they had a bunch of those pads laid out that had to get changed frequently because I was bleeding a lot. And they provided me with underwear and pads, a Perry bottle, and they would give me medicine around, I don't know, maybe 3 hours or so to help with the pain. So let me show you what everything looks like because I made sure I saved it. These are the underwear that they gave me at the hospital. This is how they look now. Here are the little leg parts. This is what it looks like. Now these underwear, they are super stretchy. You can fit your butt and your mom butt in this, okay? So this is really wide. You know, I can put it on my head, you know. They're really stretchy, but that's what you need after you have a baby because you don't want nothing tight on you at all. You still have a belly after you have a baby, but these are very helpful. You don't want to have really tight underwear at all. I also made sure that I personally brought really big underwear to the hospital, and that was helpful as well. So I had the option of wearing these, and these are disposable, by the way. These are disposable, so after you mess these up, you just throw them away. So I kept this so I could show y'all what this was like. This was the pads that they give. So on the back side, of course, as a normal pad, you have a sticky side. This would be the sticky side, but it doesn't really stick that well because only the center of this is sticky. But you know, on other pads, the wing part
is sticky as well. So this is what it looks like. They're super long, which is what you need because there's blood coming from everywhere. And you just lay these in those underwear and, you know, change your pad often, like really often. Now, I also brought my own personal pads to the hospital, and these are what my pads looked like that I brought. Now, my pads are much different from the ones at the hospital. It's like a regular pad. Mine were a bit longer than the ones at the hospital. And this is just an always pad. So this is the sticky side right here. And then of course, it has wings. And you know, you open it up like that. Those are the wings. Like this is like a huge pad. And I know it's very, very long and very big, but it was so helpful to have because you were doing so much bleeding. Now, alongside that, they give you this Perry bottle, or this is what my hospital gave me. Now, this right here, you fill it up with water and you use it to clean yourself down there because you can't sit in a tub of water. You can't really directly put soap on yourself. You just have to kind of spray it for a while and rinse it off until you can really like wash yourself down there. And for me, I tore. It wasn't no first degree, second degree, third degree, nothing like that. It was just some random tear on the side. So I did have a couple stitches, and I just had to spray the area with water. Gave me that bottle. I was so scared to use it because I'm like, is it gonna hurt if I spray water down there? But it didn't hurt, and it didn't hurt me to use the bathroom, number one or number two. It didn't hurt me. I was actually ready to do it. And there's one more thing that they gave me. Hold on. Okay, so they gave me this right here. This is called Dermablast pain burn and itch spray that you would spray on the area or in your pad, and it basically kind of cools it down. For me, I felt like this was not helpful. This is like literally almost full. I didn't really use it a lot because when I sprayed it, I felt like it hurt. Like the bottle says it's supposed to relieve pain, burn, and itch, but I feel like it was making me be painful, burn, and itch. So I didn't really use this that much. Those were all of the items that they gave me. I bled for about a month, little after a month. It just, you know, the amount of blood just decreased as time went on. My stitches, they just dissolved, they disappeared. I don't know where they went. They're gone. So when I went to my 6-month appointment, they were like, you're good, and I just left out. I thought it was something that had to get cut out, but no. That's pretty much it. And also, as far as weight, my stomach just steadily went down. The swelling in my face and my neck, it just all just slowly just melted down. I also want to add that your emotions after having a baby are all over the place. So even though a lot of times I was really happy, sometimes I would feel sad out of nowhere, or if I was sleepy, that's really when it was the craziest. If I was sleepy and the baby was just not going to sleep when he was first born, it would make me really upset because it's like, what's wrong? I don't know what's wrong with the baby. As far as my weight, like even though I was melting down and everything, it wasn't, to me, it seemed like I was just really big and everything was lopsided. My belly button was looking like, so it just, I don't know. I just really felt bad about how I looked. I had low self-esteem, which my husband, he did encourage me through that. So shout out to my man. But yeah, I'm not gonna say that I was depressed. I will not say that over my life.
But I can say that my emotions were all over the place. So now that I'm 2 months in this thing, I am doing good. I know a lot of people lose their hair during their postpartum. I have no idea if I have lost any hair. I pretty much keep it braided up or whatever. So I don't know. I have to update y'all on any other changes. Yeah. That's it for this video. I hope y'all enjoyed it. Let us know what all you want us to talk about or what videos you want us to do. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe, because you already know we're gonna be dropping a whole lot of bangers. Yeah. All right, y'all, I'm out.